हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, होप यू आर वेल एंड वर्किंग हार्ड टू अचीव योर गोल्स। सो यस्टरडे वी हैड स्टार्टेड आवर चैप्टर 5, सोल ट्रेडर एंड सोल प्रोप्राइटरशिप। देयर वी हैड डिस्कस द मीनिंग एंड डेफिनेशन ऑफ सोल ट्रेड, करेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ सोल ट्रेड एंड इवेल्युएशन ऑफ सोल ट्रेड, इट्स मेरिट्स एंड डीमेरिट्स। सो टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द सूटेबिलिटी ऑफ सोल प्रोप्राइटरशिप बिजनेस, ऑब्जेक्टिव्स ऑफ सोल प्रोप्राइटरशिप बिजनेस, फॉर्मेशन ऑफ सोल ट्रेड बिजनेस, इज वन मैन्स कंट्रोल बेस्ट इन वर्ल्ड, एक्सपेंशन ऑफ सोल ट्रेड बिजनेस एंड फ्यूचर ऑफ सोल प्रोप्राइटरशिप बिजनेस। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल डिस्कस आर की टर्म्स। सो फर्स्ट की टर्म इज मैनेजर। फॉर एग्जाम्पल, अ बैंक मैनेजर, अ स्टेशन मैनेजर और अ स्टोर मैनेजर। द पर्सन हु इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर मैनेजिंग द वर्किंग ऑफ एन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन इज कॉल्ड मैनेजर, and in return he get salary. That person is called as manager. Next our key term is partner. So partner is a person who jointly work with the other person. So an individual who joins with other individuals in an arrangement where risks and rewards are shared among them, means profits or the losses are equally shared by the persons, are called partners. So our first topic is suitability of sole proprietorship business. For example, grocery shops, small bakery shops, tailoring shops, health and doctor's clinic, stationery shops. These are the examples of sole proprietorship business that is suitable for small scale business. So sole proprietorship business organization is suitable for the following kinds of business, where there is less capital required, where there is a less risk, where there is a quick decisions are necessary, where the customer requires personal attention, where the size of business is small, where there is a liability is less, where the competition is also less, where the secrecy is desirable, and where the market of the commodity is local. So that is the points that are considered for the suitability of sole proprietorship business. Next our topic is objectives of sole trade business. So first objective is to create self-employment. So sole trade business helps people to create work for themselves instead of looking for a job outside. Next is to make use of funds. So instead of keeping funds idle, a person can start sole proprietorship. And if a person having surplus funds, he can make productive use of these resources or these funds. Next is to serve customers. So a sole trader comes in contact, a direct contact with his customers. Therefore, he can better understand the need and serve the customers easily. Next is to feed the large size of business. So the sole proprietorship firms can usually small in size. So these units provide products and services to large size or large scale business organizations. Next is independent living. So sole trade business provides opportunity for an independent living. The sole trader is his own master and free to take all the decisions. Next is equitable distribution of wealth. So sole proprietorship business helps in the distribution of income and wealth among the large number of people, and it helps to avoid monopoly and concentration of wealth in a few hands. Next topic is formation of sole proprietorship business. So sole proprietorship business is started by the initiative of single person. He prepares the blueprints of the business and arranges the necessary finance that is required in the business. And no legal formalities are required in the formation of sole proprietorship business. So the first decision involved in the formation of business is selection of a particular line of business. So this decision depends upon the demand of the product, availability of the necessary resources and the scope of earning profits in that business. Next is selection of proper site. The requirements of the customers and nearness of the market should be considered in while selecting a particular or a proper site for that business. Next is selection of size and scale of operations. So it depends upon the necessary finance that is required to start a business. So next our topic is one man's control best in the world or not? So we can say that if one has the qualities like intelligent, efficient, manager, rich, experience, then he will get success in business. The reason is that the trader need not depend upon anybody else. He decides himself, controls the business, and being the sole owner of the business, he is able to maintain secrecy, develop good relationships with the employees as well as customers. So all these factors play a great role in the success of a business. So one man control is best in the world if he manages everything. Business should be small and he knows everything. But in reality, no man can be perfect to handle everything. A single person can act efficiently only up to a limit. After that, the things goes out of his control. So we can conclude that a sole trade business is not best in the world because every person has a limit to his abilities. Next our topic is expansion of sole proprietorship business. So in order to expand the business, the sole proprietor has two options: to employ a paid manager or to associate with one or two partners. So in order to employ a paid manager, the various benefits that the sole proprietor has, like there is a sharing of management and supervisory functions, there is a reduction in the administrative work, there is a no dilution of control and no sharing of profits of the business, there is a greater expertise and the better advice taken by the paid manager, there is a retain of secrets of the business. So these are some advantages that is helpful to employ a paid manager. But there are some disadvantages, like there is a no sharing of risks, there is a no contribution of capital by the paid manager, and the manager can move out anytime from the business. There is a danger of disclosure of business secrets in the outside world. So these are some disadvantages to employ a paid manager. Next is to associate with one or more partners. So again, there are some advantages, like to provide finance and share managerial responsibilities between the partners. There is a division of work between the partners, and there is an increase in goodwill that is brought by the other partners. There is a reduction in the risks, and there is a direct relationship between the effort and reward, because the more hard work they do, the more profits they earn. Next is, there are some disadvantages, like profit sharing by the partners, and there is a possibility of conflicts between the partners because each partner has their own thoughts. So next, there is a risk of dishonesty and difficulty in removing a partner from the business. So the last topic is future of sole proprietorship business in India. So the sole proprietorship has a very bright future in India for the following reasons: as it requires small capital, it provides self-employment in India, it encourages entrepreneurship, it is best suited for small-scale business, it is most suitable for handle retail business, and the government is also making efforts to provide grants and incentives for the development of small businesses in India. So it should be clear that Indian economy is most suited for the survival and the growth of sole proprietorship business, and its scope is very bright. So this is all about today's topic. Now you have to write the question answers. So first question is, how is a sole trade business formed and describe its objectives? And second question is, explain the reasons for the survival and the popularity of sole proprietorship business in India. So there are various links that you can take help to write the answers of these questions.